Hello, Fourth. What is it? Tuesday, November 13th, and the markets on Monday. Well, you can see, look at this close. The Dow was down 31 cents, and it's pretty rare that you close that flat. But it was very similar to Friday. The range was narrower. You can see this little, from the shadow low and the wick high was less than that on Friday, but the range in the close between the open and close was very similar. Anyway, you see the difference was the volume was really light. I don't know. Is everyone waiting? I thought people had to sell because they wanted to sell in case the capital gains are going to be higher next year, so there'd be more volume. But at the moment, people are waiting to find out what the Congress is going to do insofar as debt situation. So we'll play it as it goes. I say it's the market's been down well, a couple of big drops, so we don't have really a lot of shorts here. Mainly longs, if you can see. Here's the Dow as an example. So it was an okay trade from where? What we've been showing is the parallel channel here. Let's switch. This is let's go to a 120-minute chart or maybe even a 240. Well, you can see on this, but we showed the chart, of course, in the newsletter on the weekend. But here's this parallel channel. It's been in, and it came down. And this was the 127% of Fibonacci projection we had last week, and it came down to it. It dropped below it, you can see on the ninth here, and then it rallied from that point when what? RSI went up over 30. So at a point of support, RSI goes over 30. That's basically an automatic buy. And it came back up to this very short-term little trend line there, and that's where we closed, right? On that line almost. That's right at the moment, just dropped to 2 points under it. So anyway, that's not terribly interesting, but you can see during the day, well, in fact, here's a 15-minute chart of it, and you can see there's a 5-minute bars, but you can see there was a rally. Here's until noon at this time, and I can move it over a little bit so you can see it dropped down in the morning down until 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, and then a nice rally up till 1 o'clock, and then it lost that again. So if you traded that, that's great. You would have been stopped out of there, but you're back in business now, back down to close to where we began the whole day. On the S&P, similar situation, not a lot to tell here. You can see also, like the Dow, it was down. In this case, instead of the 27.2, it was a 161.8 projection. And also the parallel channel here in this top line here and the second line here. So it hit the parallel channel bottom, which was also the 161.8, and also RSI was under 30. What happens when you go over? You buy it. So you buy it at 70, and it went up here to about 87. So that was a very nice trade. And now it's just been hanging around in this area. So we've got to wait until we have something going. I suppose now this trend line, I think we'd leave there. If you wanted to move it up just to say what we cleared the most recent, this is only two touches, not quite as valid. But still, you can watch this. If we do get a break above, that would be tradable. Also, now Natgas did pretty well during one point in the day. Let's see how they ended up closing. I can't tell you because it's changed since then. Hang on. But UGAZ, UGAZ, which is the 3X ETF for natural gas, was up really nicely. It closed up only 5.39%, but it was up higher than that during the day. And BOIL, which is closed up 3.5% for the day. So not too bad, actually. So here's what happened with the net gas futures. On the 12th, it was under the 30. RSI here, it went back over it right in this area as it started moving back up. So you may have gotten in a little lower around 350, 351 when it broke out of here and it ran up above this what parallel channel, but it got up to R1 and you can see this resistance over there. It couldn't go further. It pulled back to that channel line. So that's what you want to watch right there. If it goes below it, you don't want to, maybe you stay in this little area, but if it drops back under the 161.8 at 352 or at least 350, you might not want to hang on short term. That is, if you're trading around the core, some short term. Oh, I wanted to show one thing. We posted this chart. I think the TNA we posted in the newsletter as well, but I'm not sure if we post this lower line. Can I fit it here? Let's see. We'll switch today. So here's the movement. This is a 3X ETF for the Russell 2000. Just to show. This doesn't show properly. This is because I can't get to the whole, I can move it over so you can see it's valid. So here's September 1st of October, this low. So that is connected to the low that was around the 29th of, that isn't November. This is last September, sorry. And then we come into May, June, right here, this low. And then we come into what happened on Friday. That's the reason for the bounce right there, because those met up at the same point as 61.8 of this move, the move from 41.54 on up to 68.91. So it's retraced that and it came to this trend line. That's why this is an important level. People bought it, moved up, and now it's back to it. So if this can hold, that is a great buy point because your stop's just gonna go underneath that Friday low. Otherwise, it could be shorted under here as well because it probably dropped down to the 47.40, which is a 78.6, and you can see there is support to the left. So we'll watch this. It's either going to bounce or it's not. So it's pretty easy to play either way it goes. Okay, anyway, we did all that and that we're just talking about the Dow. We said we'd be real quick. Okay, the SPX, nothing to see there, all right? It's flat, up 18 cents. The Russell wasn't quite as flat. It did go down $1, but you can see it's still underneath that 50% retrace line and also the 200-day EMA, which is at 802. The dollar didn't do much at all. Gold didn't do much at all. GDX stayed about the same as it was, as did SLV, still with a one bar up, so not much there. It's all in the newsletter. That didn't change. So as far as the watch list stocks, really flat. CTB, Cooper Tire, is one that did go up, and the gain was okay for a while, and then it dropped back down. But here it went above the first line. That looked good. The volume needed to be stronger. It was about average volume, and it ran up as high as 24.43, and it backed off. So this is still a nice-looking pattern, so let's hopefully that is going to continue. Anyway, we have some additions to the watch list. We're not adding any shorts because I think we're going to turn back up, but it may be a while. And so we're not adding a lot of longs either. There's many things on the watch list, and we're just waiting for a better times. But this little pullback, here we had a nice flagpole and a little flag off, and it dropped, fell down for 3 days. But I like the increased volume, maybe because it's been some short covering. But it ran into some resistance, the 20-day, and then ran into the 50-day. Technically, it closed over it, but I'd like to see it above that, over that 10.52 with volume. If that happens, maybe we could reverse these fortunes, run back up to the 11.50 again. We'll watch for this trigger, and if higher volume, then that's a lot better. Now, True Religion Apparel. They had pulled back to the 200-day and 20-day. It's kind of trying to defend it. The 20-day is just above the 200-day. It wants to stay there. One way to stay above there is to break out. So let's say over about 27, set your alert somewhere underneath that. And if it starts moving right, say 26.75, 26.80, and then volume comes coming in, you can start looking towards a buying maybe over this 26.85. To 27 if there's volume behind it. ZLC, $7.51. That's what its high was, and it closed right at 750. That makes it tough. But it's been in this basic consolidation since the beginning of October. You can see it's been up and down, but it's back up there again on a little higher volume. Maybe this time it can break out. So Zale Corp, we will be watching for a possibility there. That's all. We're just adding three. Now we've got one other that we'll mention. And if it hadn't dropped so much, but look, it had this gap up and a nice flag pole, and then it lost the whole top of its pole when it came down. The next day it gapped and fell down. It's consolidating. Because the volume is lower, I decided to show it and watch for one more day and see what happens. So if it can hold this area here, maybe if it opens up, like say at 38.50, and tends to look like it's going to go up, you may be able to buy it right there with a stop just underneath this 38, this low here was 38.33. Otherwise, got to clear this range once again, 39.40-ish. We'll see. But we're not putting it on the watch list, but we are pointing it out, and we will be watching. So that's what we have anyway for Tuesday. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send tweets out before the market opens and during the day as things develop. So I hope you have a great day trading, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas in Market Wrap. See you soon. Bye.